Okay, finally here, performing for you. If you know the words, you can join in too. Okay, so I have to go beat up Mortis, and he's gonna have goose types, and goose types are weak to goose, so yeah. That's all I got for you. Looks good to me. Everything seems fine. Oh, I can't wait to play more of the bad. I almost said bad. Oh, I didn't mean bad. I meant incredibly difficult fun game. Oh, it's you. I came to this dumpy town to find some rare Bonica people were talking about. But of course the tower's closed and I can't get in. Come on, let's go. What? What? Why? Huh? Alright, sure. I guess we're fighting here instead. Windheart. I have nothing for you. God damn it. You ever listen to the version of the DK rap where every noun is replaced with coconut gun? That's a good version. It kinda lost its luster. After like the first minute of it, but it was pretty funny. Every noun is replaced by the word coconut gun. And it's funny at first, but after a while it just kinda gets, I don't know, it's one of those things that's kinda funny. But the longer it goes on, the less funny it becomes, and then you're just kinda like, oh, okay. Yeah, that cancel. Yeah, just like your comment, dumbass. Smarissa. I can't even remember what's good against this. You've never listened to the DK rap? You're missing out. Put your hands together if you want to clap as we take you through this monkey rap. Wait, what? Why am I dead? Oh, right. You have Thunderbolt. Thank you, Demo, for giving me a sub. In the original DK rap, when it gets to Chunky's line, and it's like, he may move slow, he can't jump high, but this Kong is one hell of a guy. It's like, ooh, you can't say that. But they did say it. But then in the version that came out in Melee, that's completely inaccurate, they say heck. How dare they say heck? Chat, did they fix that in the Virtual Console release? Did they change that? I actually don't know. I had that version too, the Wii U Virtual Console. This Kong's one heck of a guy. Another example of censorship ruining video games. Interesting about that is that Melee was rated T. Melee was just realistic enough to be regarded as like a T-rated game, but after that, all the games afterwards became E10. I guess it's because Melee allowed you to look up Peach's dress and see bloomers, like Tuhu's. But after that, it was that was the no-no zone after that. That's why Mai is not in Smash Ultimate. Because Mai is not for good little boys and girls. Brawl was also T, was it? I need confirmation. Yeah, but Bayonetta is okay, right? Right? Thought E10 was new? Oh, E10 didn't exist back then. Are you? Okay, no, that's ESRB ratings are different, because I was about to say the Pokemon anime originally was PG and then it went to G, but like, I guess that doesn't really, that's apples to oranges. Whatever, I have better things to do than fight with wimps like you. I doubt the rare Bonica in the tower is all that strong anyway. E10 came in 2005. What about E101 Gamma? What about that guy? I like that one. Is E10 like a secret boss? There we go. Funny thing about Bayonetta is that her attacks in her game, like, strip her. Because she uses her hair as an outfit, and then she uses her hair as attacks. Hello, challenger, do you need some advice? Why did I talk to you? You don't change your dialogue. Can you inflict any damage on your Arbonika? Yeah, sure. There's a review embargo on Last of Us 2. I'm not surprised. Well, maybe the game will be good, maybe it won't. Personally, I don't care. I didn't play the original. Don't worry. Just if you're worried about it, just give it a bit. Don't buy on day one. Everyone knows buying day one is a sucker's move. Alright? That's why I'm going to buy day one. Publishers have this habit of being really scummy. My favorite is when they don't seem to understand what red flags are. I'm a sucker. A red flag in game development is when the game comes out and you either limit review copies, you completely ignore review copies. What else? So chat, give me some red flags that indicate that a game is likely going to be bad on release. Nothing on PS5 that would let me buy day one. I agree, because most of the things that I'm interested in, it won't be coming out right away. Alice's streaming restrictions on P5R. I don't actually know what those are, but if they're anything similar to the original P5, I imagine they're pretty fucking dumb. They just won't let you stream the end of the game. It's like, well, why would I play it on stream at all if you can't stream the end? Let's see. Rigged up review copies. Yeah, definitely that. Microtransactions. Well, microtransactions usually come later. Well, okay. I take that back. Microtransactions were a big thing back in the day. That was all the rage. You were allowed to do that. And now what happens is, once the games come out and are settled and reviews are in, then you release microtransactions. Because people... Microtransactions affect the review scores for sure. Ooh! Very, very reminiscent of the Toavania version. Looks really good. I like the butter. It's Sephiroth. Chat. It's fucking Sephiroth. She's got one wing. She's got one wing. That's really cool. One wing butterfly. You go. Burn powder. Oh, that's gonna kill me, isn't it? She doesn't... Oh, it's just Willow. Never mind. Try Miss Ball. Not a ghost type anymore. There we go. I'm pretty sure the reason loot boxes and whatnot have been taking a massive hit is because Battlefront 2. When Battlefront 2 existed, she's double death one butterfly. Nice. Double black death one wing butterfly. The ultimate spell card. Becomes a timeout spell. At the end, you have to dodge meteor. EA is a pretty interesting company, isn't it? I feel like EA wouldn't really thrive as much as it does right now if it wasn't for its sports games. Then you on the other end of the spectrum, you have 2K. The last WrestleMania game came out was so bad that it seems to have the whole license in a tricky spot. Because when you have a license for something like that and you fuck up, there's a good chance that they don't want to renew contracts. So there's a chance that WWE 2K, whatever the fuck it was, is just donezo. You might get one next year, but I don't know. It seems like it's really risky. Seems like it's really risky. I heard that 2K, the basketball game was caught up in some controversy the last two releases. Christian told me that, but he didn't specify, and I forgot to ask. So I don't know exactly what that was. EA also has a bunch of their microtransactions, you're right. That would indeed do it. Online only is another red flag. I don't understand how people can make games that require you to be online at all times. That is the stupidest shit ever. It's like Bethesda when they push that Bethesda account nonsense. Actually, do they still do that? I know they're, I'm pretty sure when Bethesda released all the Doom classics again, they made it so you had to be logged into your Bethesda account at all times to play it. That's silly. EA better than Activision? Well, let's be real here. They're both awful. Really, I suppose you're just comparing cockroaches to, What's another awful bug? Shiomu. Rats are not bugs, but close enough. There we are. That's just trying to get money by even, I started reading your sentence, and then the next message popped up, and then I started reading the second half of that sentence. So, the sentence I got was Bethesda and trying to get money by, and that's even questionable. I was like, what? Where the fuck did that come from? What? That sentence doesn't make any sense. They've tried monetizing mods for Skyrim, like, twice. The first time they tried it, it fucked up. Horribly. It received a massive backlash, and then you know what they did? They did it again. They did it again, but they changed the name, as if that was actually gonna work. Oh my god! What was it called, chat? It was called something different the second time. I only remember the second time it came around because that was when they announced the Evil Within 2. And I was really excited for that game because I thought the Evil Within 1 was really good. Creation Club, was that the first or second one? Because I'm pretty sure it had two different names, but it was essentially the same thing. But yeah, but when Bethesda's E3 trailer, or E3 presentation, they had the Evil Within 2 in there, and I was like, oh, that's awesome, because I like the Evil Within. And then that was it. Why did you do that? What? Alright, sure, go ahead. See if I care. That game got no marketing at all. Came out, and it was... I don't think it was bad. I truly don't think that Evil Within 2 was bad, but I also feel like there were a lot of things in it that... Well... I don't know, I think the first game was way better. But I still enjoyed my time with the second game. But goddamn, there was no marketing for that. It just kind of came out and that was it. That was just the end of it. We're probably never going to get a third one either. Oh well. Doom Eternal DRM fiasco. That was great, wasn't it? That's how I learned, chat taught me what Denuvo was, and now I know. Now I know why it's bad. Now I, too, can form an opinion on things that I know nothing about. Still, I was never really huge on Bethesda, I suppose. I like Fallout 3 a lot. And I like New Vegas more, but New Vegas was developed by Obsidian. That reminds me of the... when Bethesda promised pay... If New Vegas received a certain review score, and it got 1 point below the agreed amount, and then Bethesda was like, well, guess we can't pay you. That was cool. And now Obsidian will never make another Fallout game, even though they're definitely more equipped to handle that kind of game than those fucking idiots are. Just wait, chap. Just wait. 2021? Sorry, 2025? We're gonna have Skyrim 2. Electric Boogaloo, and when the game comes out and it has microtransactions for good armor, online only, paid memberships, bugs out the wazoo, and player bannings. We'll see on 2026 when Bethesda announces their patches, or they hit us with that promotional wheel again. Good of you to come. Here in Necrotique, Bonica have been revered. It's said that a legendary Bonica will come down to appear before a truly powerful trainer. I believe that tale, so I've secretly trained here all my life. As a result... Wait, secretly, what? As a result, I can see now. I can now see what others cannot. Just a bit more, with a little more, I can see the future in which I met the legendary Bonica. You're gonna help me reach that. Okay. Here's how the devs fucked up. The thing is, I learned that... Well, this is a good sprite. A lot of the time, it's not even the devs' fault. The studios do their best with what they have to work with, but they're either inexperienced, or they're getting... Breathing down their neck, the big corporate execs who have no idea what the fuck goes on at all, and they're just like, this'll probably work, right? And then it doesn't. It never fucking works. Why would it ever work? Bethesda's another story, though. Bethesda always seems to fuck up, no matter what they do. And I don't understand how they manage to keep doing that. This guy's levels are now matching mine. That's worrying. Great. Okay, good. This is Aki's theme. Layla. Layla's part water, isn't she? I'll just keep using Nightmare until racing goes down. 72. Oh my god. Oh, that's really not good. Alright, I'm still confused. I hate Pokemon. I'm fine. Or you can just crit me. Oh my, I fucking hate Pokemon, man. Why? Where do I even go from here? I don't remember what type she is. I should know this. I have one. Ghost, obviously, so Thrash doesn't work. Reason Ghost. So she's weak to... She's weak to Heart, but I don't have Heart anymore. Oh, Reason's weak to Beast. Should kill. Nice. Kogasa. Kogasa's pure ghost with water moves. She's gonna have water and ice moves, so I need to be careful about this. It seems like Suiko is just my best bet here, because Momiji's gonna leak the water and flying types are weak to ice. However, he has a lot of Pokemon, so I gotta be careful here. Shaman King's getting a new anime next year, you have 20 years. Yeah, I heard, but I don't really know anything about Shaman King. It was on TV when I was a kid, and that's about all I got. I wonder if Faith is decent against ghosts. Surf is stronger, so this might kill. Two serfs would have killed instead. A little late for that, I suppose. Is that a berry? Oh, fuck. He's gonna use a healing item, so I'll Tailwind. You're back with back pain? I'm here with Pokemon pain. Hitting myself with confusion twice to do a crit. It's good. I don't know if plus one will do it, but I'm worried that trying to set up again will be a bad idea. Almost. Alright, I'm gonna load up on the attacks. You wanna set up, that's fine. I could have set up again. Shit, I really wasn't sure if it'd heal or not, but if I had committed, I would have eaten shit for it, for sure. So I'll just keep using sword. How many swords do I have? I have plenty. He did it again! What are you doing? There we go. So chat, we got more Paper Mario information. I don't know if any of you have seen that. Oh, there's the crit. It seems like, I haven't actually seen it myself. Attack Murasa. Ooh. Got the captain's coat. Yeah, I didn't watch it myself, but I heard that it was nice to crit. I heard it was not as promising again. It just kind of sucks that I don't understand how the first two Paper Marios had unique Bomb characters, right? Merlin. And then now we have Bobby. He's just the Bomb. He has no character. But we have Bombette, who was a pink girl bomb, which, I mean, yeah, that's not exactly the greatest character, like, attribute ever, just a pink bomb, but it's also the first Paper Mario, so it was still nice. Like, we had a Goomba with a hat, a pink bomb, and a Koopa with a blue shell, and that's all we needed to be happy. That's all we needed. And then in the second one, we had Lady Goomba, we had Koopa with bandages and a hoodie, and then we had Old Man Bomb. And Old Man Bomb was great, because Old Man Bomb had a good backstory and reason for his actions, and or lack of actions. And now here we are, we have Bob. My name is Bob. You think they'd want to return to their roots, considering the Mario and Luigi series is fortunately on a little bit of a hiatus. As the fog badge, normally it would let you use surf, but I see you have a soul badge. For you, it shows me you've beaten me. If you want to keep working at it, I hope you keep working at your goal. Don't let your dreams be dreams, just work at it and make a reality. You got it, son. Mario Luigi Dream Team is really good. I don't think it's as good as Superstar Saga or Bowser's Inside Story, but I do think it's better than Partners in Time. I think Partners in Time is my least favorite. And the only reason I say that is because I haven't played Paper Jam, because I was so bored after the first hour or two of Paper Jam that I just couldn't be bothered to continue it. So I don't even know if the game is good after that point. It's like, oh, it's Mario and Luigi, now you can press Y button sometimes, I guess. Paper Mario's gonna suck forever. Yep. It certainly is. I like how Paper Mario has managed to create cult classics with two games. With a really polished battle system that works. And then Super Paper Mario came out, and while Super Paper Mario wasn't the same, it was still really good in its own right, and after that it was all downhill. Sorry, but the tower's closed off, it's too dangerous to go inside. But I wanna go this one. I really hate that. I just don't understand how Nintendo can create a perfect formula and then just not do anything. I have the badge, let me through. Go ahead, please. Yeah, that's right, fuck off. Why did he go that way? Why didn't he just walk to the side? Tintas off limits anyone that has a 6-6 badge. Go ahead, please. I was gonna. Super Mario had a great story, in my opinion. That was its strength. And it also had a very unique take on the 2D formula, in my opinion. But I like the turn-based combat of Paper Mario and Paper Mario Thousand Door, and I know a lot of people did too. But then Sticker Star came out, and not only was Sticker Star completely uninspired, like Paper Mario had a really good job of creating characters, new characters exclusive to the universe of Mario. Even in the original that takes place in the Mushroom Kingdom and like Toad Town and all that, I'm trying to cover the secret legend of Bonega said to land here. That was still fine, right? And then Thousand Year Door had a very, very colorful cast of characters with a great area. Like, there's so many memorable characters in that game. Super Paper Mario, I wasn't huge on the partners personally, and I think Flipside and Flopside was a bit goofy, but I liked playing as the main four characters, and I liked the story of it. There's some babbies. See. And then Sticker Star happened, and Sticker Star was the plot of the first game, but somehow worse. And they made it so combat is you use consumables to fight in combat. Genius idea right there. And the best part is since there's no actual EXP, using consumables is just a waste of resources. Because you know what you get for winning battles? You get money. You know what you use the money for? To buy more consumables to use for battle. Do you see how that cycle doesn't exactly work? There's no merit to battling. You only fight bosses. And I'm pretty sure some bosses have special attacks. Like, there are special stickers you can use on bosses to pretty much trivialize them. Of course, I've never played the game myself, so if there are any diehard Paper Mario Sticker Star fans that want to tell me that I'm wrong, please go right ahead. I will listen. And laugh to myself, but I will listen. Be more of a negative impact on Paper Mario series. Yep. I like the guy, but he really did not have a good thing to say about that. Pretty sure he's also the reason F-Zero hasn't got another game, too. How do you get stronger? You don't. That's the best part. You just don't. You fight battles, you win money. You fight more battles, you win money. You buy more items to fight battles, you win more money. So all you really have to do is just not fight. He's also why Star Fox Zero is so weird. Miyamoto deserves. There are, why are there so many fucking staircases? Miyamoto is, I have respect for him because he's obviously created a ton of great games. But he's so focused on innovation that sometimes it doesn't always work out. It's very hit or miss with him sometimes. Star Fox Zero is not a good game. It uses a really forced control scheme. And it's awkward. And the thing is, you can't even say that a forced, awkward control scheme makes a bad game. Because Kid Icarus Uprising has one of the most annoying control schemes I've ever played. Especially since I'm left-handed. Being left-handed in that game requires me to move Pit with the A, B, and YX buttons, and it's fucking weird. I don't have a D-pad, or I don't have a control stick, and the circle pad extension that puts a stick on the right side of your DS does not exist anymore, so I can't do that either. So I could never do the flying segments on high difficulty because I couldn't maneuver. If I wanted to move in like a diagonal direction, I'd hold two buttons at once instead of just turning the stick. It was more difficult than it needed to be. But that game was so damn good that I played so much of it, but I just never could beat it on the highest difficulties. Oh, it's the old man. Huh. Well, alright, cool. Where am I going? He was the legendary the whole time. There's a monkey ball game on DS, right? I think it was called Touch and Go? I don't remember. Anyway, Andrew had it. And there was a mini game where you're supposed to use the buttons to like shoot, and then you have to turn yourself with the stylus on the touchscreen. Being left-handed with that game was awful because you couldn't move. I had to use my non-dominant hand to turn the way I'm facing, and I couldn't use the left hand, because if I used my left hand, I took my hand off the control stick. That's what it was, yeah, so you use the control stick to move, and you control your camera with the touchscreen. But being left-handed, holding a stylus in my right hand was not easy, so I couldn't play that game properly at all. Worst game. I don't know where I need to go. I'm trying to climb this weird tower. Don't worry, I'll get up there eventually. Alright. Control schemes can make or break the game, but there are some exceptions. I would say that Kid Icarus is an exception to the rule. Because, like, it's a good game with a wonky-ass control scheme that Sakurai just refuses to change. What a... cunt. God damn it. There's Big Sword Lady. There's just a bunch of sword ladies in here. And Yoki as well. Big Sword Man. No, we'll get a new Kid Icarus game 25 years after the release of Uprising. Hades said it himself, and would Hades lie to us? That game was so beautifully well written. That's pretty much what sold it for me, I think. Is the fact that the game was just so well written. There were so many good character interactions in it. That even though the gameplay was still fine, but even though the control scheme was kind of whack as all hell, everything else about the game made up for it. Yep. Because at first it just starts with, oh, it's Medusa. And then you deal with Pit and Palutena as they deal with all of the henchmen. And they're all very interesting characters. They're all very memorable characters, and I like that. Oh, I fucked up. God damn it. And then, once you beat Chapter 9, you actually get to the main bulk of the real game, where Hades shows up, and Viridi shows up, and a whole bunch of new characters show up, and it's like, damn. That game was already really good when I was playing it, and I didn't know anything about it at all, so when Hades showed up, the game just got infinitely better, and I was loving it. What a great game. I never 100%ed it. I couldn't beat the third checkerboard because it required you to beat stages on 9.0, and I can't do flying segments on that high of difficulty. It was too difficult for me. I couldn't do it. I really truly believe that the control scheme held me back, though. That's such a massive pain in the ass to do. I blew it, didn't I? Fuck yeah, I did. Hold on, I'll get it. I'll get it. Don't worry, I got it. Like, the one thing about Nintendo that does kind of irritate me is how they... What is that? Who? Who? Sure. Here. Sendai. Who's Sendai? It's a Seiho character. Oh. How could a shrine maiden from the past not much is known about her? Wait, what? Is this Beta Reimu? What? Are you serious? There we go. Beimu. And I translates to previous. Huh. Plus Rainbow's mom. That would make sense if you think of it like, if you try to put reason behind why she's no longer used, you could say that she was the original Miko before Rainbow. So Rainbow is her successor. In other words, the character from Osana Rainbow. Oof, ooh, there's the heartbreak. There goes my heart. It's a Mugen fan character, from what I know. Oh, is it? No. Give me a second, chat. Give me a second. I'll figure this out. Please be patient. I got it. Okay. I remember this place in Crystal Kai, so I hated it. So, as I was saying, Nintendo... I guess it's more so just Miyamoto than anything, but... They'll disregard IPs because it's like, okay, well, we can't create anything innovative for it, so we don't want to use it. Captain Falcon is a pretty good example of that. They can't think of anything they want to do for F-Zero, so what that means is F-Zero just gets to not exist anymore. However, Mario Kart 8 will exist forever, and then Mario Kart 9 will come out too. Let's be real, they just don't want to compete with themselves. The fact that there's a couple F-Zero references throughout Mario Kart as well sells it on me. And then of course we have... I remember back in the early days, real early days... What's this do? I don't even know what's going on. For when the new Super Mario Brothers came out for DS, and it was really good. That was a good game. It was a revival of the series in the 2D format, and I thought that was really cool. And then it happened again. 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 Isn't that great? Let me think. So there was the original, right? Then there was, what came next? The Wii one? The Wii one was four-player co-op. That one was okay. I thought that was okay. And then there was the second one on 3DS, the Golden Coins, right? Then there was New Super Mario Bros. Wii U, which was just New Super Mario Bros. On the Wii U. And then there was New Super Luigi U, which was New Super Mario Bros. On the Wii U, but Luigi and Nabbit. And now there's the one with the Super Crown, right? I get that right? Do I have them all? They keep calling it new, and it's fucking annoying, because it's not new. It's ironically one of the stalest formulas they do. But Cat Suit? Wrong game. You're thinking of Squirrel Suit. Cat Suit came from 3D World, which is a great game. Mario 3D World is a fantastic game. Mario 3D Land and 3D World are both good games. I can accept either of them being better than the other, but personally, I like 3D World more. I just think it looks nicer and has better music, that's all. But I like the idea of the 2D style format, but in a 3D space. It worked pretty good. And it's a lot more interesting, in my opinion. It creates more interesting environments than the original, the original format. Super Crown is 2 years old. Are you serious? Thunder Punch. I can't believe Bowsette is 2 years old. She's naked. It's just an angel. It's art. God damn it. She's got a belly button. What do you mean you use the lunatic? What's that do? Does it kill me? Am I dead? Am I dead? No, I'm not. It's not explicit. No, it's art. Thank you, Demo, for getting another sub. Chat, if I can play Animal Crossing and stare at a statue's pee-pee, this should be okay. I'm just saying. Angels are fine art. I mean, she is a relic of the past. Uh-oh. And she's gone. Thank you, Yo-Yo, for gifting a sub. Well, that was quick! VVT is a maid android. Eric is her master. She can change bullets into energy. Look, I did it. That was easy. Can I fly off of this place? Why not? I'm on the top of the tower and I can't fly off it. Alright. Well, that was good. And incredibly quick. I'm pretty sure that was a legendary, though, so... Two balls is pretty good. Yeah, I'll take it. So where can I go now? Catch rate was 3. Oh, then I'm just really good. So, I think I know where I need to go next. But just to satisfy my curiosity. I'm gonna go to the right and see if the gate guardian here removes me. Yeah, he does. Sorry, but the route has closed yet. You know what that reminds me of, chat? The gate guardian card from Yu-Gi-Oh. Was that card good? So I remember correctly, in order to play the Gate Guardian, you needed to play Sujin, Raijin, and Fujin, right? You needed to play all three of those monsters, all of which were 7-star monsters, and then you had to sacrifice all three of them to summon the Gate Guardian. But I'm pretty sure the Gate Guardian was not immune to traps or magic, so you could just trap hole the fucker. A 3 in 255 chance. Okay, so I can hit that. But I hit myself in confusion and get critted all over the place? Where's the justice? It doesn't make any sense. Fly high into the sky. Three cards that make up Gate Guardian by themselves were better than Gate Guardian. I had Sujin, actually. Sujin was the only card I had. Oh right, I forgot Suga's in the front. I remember Wall Shadow. That's a card I had. Attack to Kiko. Yeah, let's punch it again. I think you needed to use it with a magic card that, like, combined it with a wall. I thought you actually needed to have Lambreth Wall in play to use it. Which, by the way, is a weird-ass monster. And a real one. It's a 5-star no-effect monster with 0 attack. And 3,000 defense. And what's funny about that is when you think about how equip spells work, and that you can put attack points onto monsters. So if you equipped the Axe of Despair to Lambreth Wall, you would have a Lambreth Wall with 1,000 attack points, and it would just be a wall with an axe. How does that attack? I'm just trying to eat, like. Even if you increase the wall's attack power, it's a fucking wall. How is it going to attack you? Lambreth Wall, attack him directly and win me the duel. It's like, what do you want me to do? Imagine animating that. Imagine being the guy who had to animate Lambreth Wall, declaring a direct attack on your life points. It just falls on you, but it can't, because it's a Lambreth Wall. Like, look it up. Look up the card Lambreth Wall. It's literally just a Lambreth. Like, it can't do anything. It doesn't even make sense. Well, shit. This is interesting, isn't it? Let's use Surf. Same way a bunch of dust particles prevented monsters from being summoned because they fill up the field. Hey, that's different. That's called, what are they called? Scapegoat? Interesting thing about Scapegoat. Scapegoat is four mooks that can't be sacrificed. However, there's another card that's called Stray Lambs, which is two mooks that can be sacrificed. Pretty sure she's Reason, so this should... Yeah, that would be very effective. But Strength could do it. Axe of Despair was a kind of a wacky-ass equip card. It was 1,000 raw increase of your attack points, and if the monster holding the card was destroyed, you could discard a card from your hand to bring it back out from the graveyard. And it's like, okay, let me just have this infinite plus 1,000 attack bullshit. It kind of reminds me of Horn of the Unicorn, but the thing is, Horn of the Unicorn itself, while kind of good, it could really backfire. Because Horn of the Unicorn would always reset to the top of your deck when the monster it's equipped to is destroyed. which meant that if you didn't have any cards to use, and then you had to keep doing, like, you had to pull that, it means you lost a turn. So that could be really bad in that sense. Because, let's face it, card games are pretty heavily reliant on drawing. That's why a card like the Yatagarasu is so incredibly, like, notorious, despite it being, on paper, not an amazing monster. Yu-Gi-Oh! Season 1 had no rules for the game, just set. My favorite was when Yugi used Catapult Turtle to fling... I don't even remember what he flung. He flung something at the Castle of Dark Illusions to destroy its flotation ring, which caused the darkness it caused to dissipate, and then it collapsed on all of the guy's monsters. And then it left him wide open. I was like, yeah, that makes sense. Did I say notorious? No, but I should've. I definitely should've. Oh, I see. I didn't see that yo-yo. Yeah, he just used swords and revealing light so he could see it. It's like, what the fuck? That's so stupid! It was Gaia. He flung Gaia the Fierce Knight. You ever think about how when Yugi fuses Curse of Dragon and Gaia the Fierce Knight, it gets like 100 extra attack points? That's not how that's supposed to work. When you fuse monsters, they're supposed to become stronger. What about that monster is even remotely stronger? If you put a knight on a dragon and its attack points go up by 100, just keep him off the fucking dragon. You're better off having the dragon and the knight. You don't put them together. I also like when Polymerization's weird, because sometimes the fusions make sense. Like, when the Elemental Heroes fuse, it makes sense. You fuse Clayman and Bubble Man, and you get Mudball Man. That makes sense. You combine Bursinatrix and Avion, and you get a Flame Wingman. But then you have some of the older fusions, where you fuse, I forget who it was, chat. You fuse, like, Witch of the Black Forest with something, and you get Musician King. It's like, what? Like, Flame Manipulator and Saki the Legendary Samurai, or Swordsman, makes sense. And then Flame Swordsman stopped being a fusion monster because it did not need to be a fusion monster. Just hit it with the extra sensory. If it was Sangen and Black Witch Forest, two notorious searches to make Sandwich, which doesn't search anything. Both those cards were banned at one point. They just used Prank. It did a lot of damage. Chat, what made Lambreth tank? Because I remember that card. I'm pretty sure the brothers used it, right? Forget their name. The guys with Gate Guardian had Lambreth tank, right? Don't you have to... Cyberwolf and Cannon Soldier. Yeah, that makes no fucking sense. How does that create Lambreth tank? Oh, I made a mistake. Ah, shit. Para and Docs. Yeah, those guys. And that's when Yugi fused his summon skull with red eyes and created Black Skull Dragon. But the thing about those fusions is that they're absolute bullshit. Like, think about it for a second. In order to play a fusion monster, you need the card in your extra deck, right? But what kept happening is that Yugi, they would just pull a fusion monster out of their ass. And then suddenly one of them would have the card for it? That's impossible! I think Meteor Bee Dragon is cool, but I don't think that ever appeared in the anime. I like Red Eyes Darkness Dragon, that's one of my favorite dragons. Alright, time to go heal that off. Flame Swords was never treated as a fusion, that's true. Because I don't even know why they bothered making it a fusion. Did Joey ever actually fusion summon it? I don't know. Because I know he didn't in... I almost said Gen 1. He didn't in Duelist Kingdom because the rules didn't exist. But when Flame Swordsman came out, they made it a fusion monster for some reason. But I feel like he actually did use Polymerization at one point to summon Flame Swordsman during the Domino City arc. But he usually summons the Swordsman of Landstar and then uses his Grateful Dice and Skull Dice and Tam Wizard. When you think about it, Joey's entire dueling strategy is just RNG. He'd be better off playing Pokemon than he would Yu-Gi-Oh! But he's so goddamn lucky that he keeps winning duels he does not deserve to win. Yeah, you gotta respect that strategy, I suppose. He knows how to win. He was good with Jinzo. He got that from a cheater. My Jinzo! Jinzo became more, more iconic than Red Eyes. Chat, you remember the episode of Yu-Gi-Oh! When Joey is controlled by Merrick? And he has to fight Yugi at the harbor, where they both have anchors, like, chained to their ankles. So the loser gets drowned in the harbor. That was a good episode. I think my favorite part about that episode was when Joey broke through the mind control and declared an attack. And I was like, sorry, Yugi, I gotta do it. And then the duel was over, and then Yugi was like, no, actually, I activate this magic card that you'll never see again and have never seen up to this point, which makes it so I take the damage that was originally intended for you, and now I lose instead, even though the duel has already been, like, declared over. You know, that level of bullshit. And then Yugi flies away instead, and it's like, what happened here? Oh. Yugi won Joey's Red Eyes from Rare Hunter, and then he promised that Joey can have it back if Joey beats Yugi in a duel, and then the very next season, Joey has Red Eyes. Did he? Did Joey get Red Eyes back? All I remember about that is the Rare Hunter. The Rare Hunter with Exodia took Red Eyes from Joey, and he threatened to rip up the card if Joey told Yugi at all about his strategy. And that's when Yugi pulled out some bullshit. That was still within the realm of bullshit, because Yugi summoned, like, Yugi summoned Gamma the Magnet Warrior and summoned Skull, and some reason, because Gamma the Magnet Warrior was an electric-type monster, it made Summon Skull stronger. And it's like, what? That's not how this works. I thought you were trying to learn the rules. He did, so he beat Yugi after Battle City. Wasn't it that in that duel against Yugi and Joey, Yugi ended up switching Red Eyes into Joey's control as a way to, like, weaken the... Hyper you again? Your reason, I remembered. Summon Skull had synergy with electricity shenanigans in the anime. So at least it was consistent bullshit. Yeah. Summon Skull is actually an incredibly good monster. For some reason it had more attack points than Dark Magician, and it had less sacrificial cost. Which is just like, why? 2,500 attack monster, and it's only like a 6-star. And then Dark Magician's a 7-star monster with 2,400. They didn't even care about the rules, man. It wasn't equal. It was stronger than Dark Magician. That's the craziest part. What was funny to me is that Blue Eyes and Dark Magician were equal summoning costs, but Blue Eyes was absurdly better. Yet somehow Yugi always won anyway. They were both 2,500? What? Oh, I'm thinking of Red Eyes, aren't I? Because Red Eyes is a 7-star and he's 2,400. Why is Red Eyes so much worse? Yeah, okay, hold on. Dark Magician's points are 2,500 attack and 2,100 defense, correct? Because I keep thinking it's 2,400 attack and 2,000 defense, but that's Red Eyes. That is Red Eyes' stat point. However, Red Eyes could combine with a bunch of shit. Red Eyes is a bad archetype? Well, I don't know about, well, probably nowadays, but it did get some cards. For example, it had Red Eyes Darkness, which is a really good monster. It had Red Eyes Beat Chick, which allowed you to special summon a Red Eyes. It's a normal type monster, so it can take advantage of older rules. Bow bow. Yeah. I say older rules, but what I mean is, like, cards. There are some, what? Oh, you sell berries. Do you sell Leppa berries? Enigma fruit. Can be ground up into powder as an ingredient for medicine. What's that one do? Starberry. Sharp relays is one stat. It's random. What are these berries? These are real, aren't they? Yeah, these are real. However, aren't these from Gen 4? They're for Pokeblocks, aren't they? What I really wanted was there it is. Leva berries, just in case. You never know when you're gonna need them. That's pretty good. Tori is everywhere, yeah. Her hat is not a green, though. I don't know if it's the real Notori. She's got a cat farm. Sorry, cat-dog farm. I'm leading one right now, I don't remember. Haven't found any issues to poke fun at yet, don't worry. I'm good. E-reader berries. Well, the lychee berry's on Mirage Island. But I've just never done that before. I remember when Time Wizard back in Duelist Kingdom did exactly what it doesn't do. Time Wizard's effect was hilarious because it was just like, alright, we sped up the flow of time, which created Thousand Dragon. And then Thousand Dragon was just a fusion between Baby Dragon and Time Wizard. But that's not even the best part. The best part about that was when he did that, and then Rex Raptor's Red Eyes was just stone. For some reason, using Time Wizard's effect made Red Eyes Black Dragon turn to stone and then crumble. And it's like, what? That doesn't even make sense. Time Wizard made the Harpy super old. Time Wizard does a lot of things. Time Wizard also made a Dark Magician super old too. Remember that? He turned the Dark Magician into the Dark Sage. Also, you know that card that Mai used in her duel against Yugi in Duelist Kingdom, the Mirror Wall card? I forget what that card does. But I can tell you that it requires 2,000 life points every standby phase to keep up on your side of the field, which would have immediately cost Mai the duel. That said, Tomb World also requires 1,000, which is just fucking stupid. Why would you create cards like that? Because you can only realistically keep that on your side of the field for 7 turns. And if you can't use every single turn, you're not doing that. I don't know what to do here, I'm just crunch. Burning land needs 500 every turn. Yes, that's correct. 4,000 max life points in the anime. No. There was 2,000 in Duelist Kingdom, remember? Duelist Kingdom had no rules. It was just 2,000 life points and you could summon whatever you want. Yugi could summon Dark Magician on turn 1. And if you didn't play a monster to defend yourself, you just lost. That's the level of bullshit we're talking about. Oh. Forgot I had that up. I wanted to look at Tomb World there. Tomb World and Mirror. Let me see. Tomb World. Activate this card by paying 1,000 life points. Oh, it was one-time use. Man, I'm pretty sure I had that card, too. Let me see Mirror Wall. That's not what I wanted. Alright, Mirror Wall. What did this do? Each of your opponent's monsters that conducted an attack while this card was face-up on the field has its attack halved as long as this card remains on the field. During each of your standby phases, pay 2,000 life points or destroy this card. Yeah, so Mirror Wall I was correct on. I didn't realize Tomb World was a one-time cost. That still doesn't make it that good. However, Tomb Monsters were kind of good. No, it's because I'm using Display Capture. I forgot it's not Game Capture. So it's capturing my monitor, and I've just cropped it to only capture the game, that's all. So when I popped it open, it popped open on the YouTube page that I was last on. Okay, there we go. Why did I switch into this? Mirror Wall was a meta card in Duel Links when it first started. I just don't understand how you're supposed to keep that level of cost up. Because it's 2,000 life points. You only get that for 3 turns. Chat, what's your favorite Yu-Gi-Oh card? It can be for whatever stupid reason you want. Mine is the self-destruct button. No, not you. You again? There's no need to be alert. I don't bother with wimps like you. Speaking of weaklings, the city's gym leader isn't here. Supposedly taking care of a sick Bonica at the lighthouse. Boo-hoo. Just let sick Bonica go. Bonica. That camp battle is worthless. Why don't you go train at the lighthouse? Who knows? It may make you a bit of a better trainer. Princess of Tsurugi and Queen's Double. The thing you have is an idol dex, right? No, it's an art book. Dev! Where's the dev? This guy's text is outdated. TM1 Launch a Spider. Launch a Spider is so cool, but it's such a bad card. Four islands beyond the sea are covered by that whirlpool. I like the self-destruct button because it's so stupid. Just if you're losing by 7,000 life points, you can activate this card and make the duel end in a draw. It's like, why? The sea is sweet. Sunsets on the sea are marvelous. Sing with me. Also, Final Dust, what was it called? It's the card where you discard your 5 cards in your hand, you destroy everything on the field. That card was hilarious. The sea is pitch black, we can't sail yet. Is it? It looks blue to me. T-ship pier. Hold on, I'm just looking around to see everything. The Sparks card. Left leg of Exodia. Only the left leg. Along the way to see them where there are 4 deserted islands. Bad kids are taken to the islands as punishment. Whenever I get in trouble, Daddy always scares me. Oh, I guess the lighthouse is off. Why did he tell me to train at the light? What the fuck? And that's weird. Somebody want to call the dev? C. Why, yes. That is the C. What are you doing here, little brat? Go away, I'll make you leave. So, release was censored? Probably. They probably put a close on her or something. Pokemon cards had censorship too. It's not anything out of the ordinary. You're back? Oh, just in time, Dev. We found a couple things I need to talk with you about. Chat, do you remember the Blue Eyes Shining Dragon card? I actually had friends who owned it. And in order to summon the Blue Eyes Shining Dragon, you have to sacrifice a Blue Eyes Ultimate Dragon. How the fuck are you even doing that? At least with Red Eyes Darkness, all you needed to do was get rid of a regular Red Eyes, but now you have to get rid of a whole Blue Eyes Ultimate. I'm not Kaiba, I don't have one of those. Why would you sacrifice it? Because Shining Dragon has a good ability, and it gains attack points equal to the amount of dragons in your discard pile. And since in order to actually sacrifice a Blue Eyes Ultimate, that requires 3 Blue Eyes and a Blue Eyes Ultimate, which is 4 monsters, so it would pretty much even out its attack stat. But it's still like, who the fuck has a Blue Eyes Ultimate they can just summon and then get rid of? I have to tell the boss, grr, you're not ruining our plans here. Alright, Dev, I have a few things to show you. First of all, this. The sign says C. I'm not quite sure what this means. You can go behind the lighthouse, which is kind of weird. And this guy up here, this kid with the hat right here, he says I have an idol dex. That's also outdated. I have an art dex. There you go. So yeah, I found a sequence of broken as soon as you left. I did it. I'm the best. Let's go check this bookcase. I'm behind it was intentional, but yeah. Yeah, I wasn't sure about that. It kind of freaked me out when I did it first, because I've never actually done that. Olivine City Gym by Leader Jasmine, the steel-clad defense girl. Sorry, but Jasmine's currently the dev. Dev. Jasmine is currently at the light who. Oh, I get it. It's like two who, but instead of two, it's light. Light who. I get it. I was trying to take care of her sick Bonica with that Team Rocket group T. Hmm? Title T? T them hostage. What a cruel group of no good punks holding them hostage like that. Now I am the gym leader. That's where the SC was from. You know what? You might actually be right about that. On the sea, the only thing you can count on is your own good self. I'm so proud of my buff bod. Olivine's cafe menu is full, chock full of heady fare for beefy sailors. You mean hearty? Whenever I roll into this town, I always visit the Olivine Cafe. Everything on the menu makes you feel stronger. Can't stop eating. I could eat. Route 40, Olivine, Cienwood. Although you can't see it from here, Cienwood is across the sea. Which way am I supposed to go? I'm gonna assume you want me to do the lighthouse. So I'll do that first. It's not a Team Rocket building. So you're the one who scared off the guard, huh? Well, it just means we get to have fun. I need to go to Jasmine first, because you talk to Jasmine in the lighthouse, and she'll tell you about the secret medicine. If you don't talk to her about the secret medicine first, then you cannot get the secret medicine from the guy in Cienwood. In Crystal Kaizo, they actually swapped the building where you get the secret medicine and where you get strength. So the building where you get strength is now on Cienwood, and the building where you get secret potion is on Olivine. However, you need strength in order to reach Jasmine, so it's fucking evil. What an evil game. The secret medicine is just very strong, effective medicine. I wonder what that, maybe the Ampharos has Ligma. Maybe that's why it needs it. One Pokemon, really? Alright. Sure. That wasn't fun. That wasn't fun at all. It's Maribel. I remember you from Sofco. You'll pay for making Team Rocket fall. I did nothing wrong, chat. I purely exist. I exist in an eternal state of suffering. Holy Jesus. I don't remember what type you are. I'll just press crunch and hope it works, please.
I didn't hear a negative.
Aha. Let me try cut. Neutral. Okay. Attack Rumia. Attack Rumia has access to the flamethrower move. Wait, that's not the Rumia I'm used to. That should be fine, though. There she goes. Say goodbye. I want to go back to Goldenrod and listen to that music. Defense Familia. Oh, I wonder what's happening here. She's ducking. Speaking of Familia, last night I read a longer one, a longer doujin than I'm usually when I read those doujins. They're only a couple pages long, but sometimes I find ones that are like actually fairly lengthy. And it was a Scarlet Devil retelling, which that gets some people excited, I'm sure. EOSD, embodiment of the Scarlet Devil, all over again. Maribel, I know I'm putting a stop to this. But it was a battle manga, and it was actually pretty well done. I liked it. It had a couple things about it that, you know, they were just kind of there. But for the most part, yeah, it was pretty good. I liked it. Oh, that's neutral. It's a battle manga. Well, it's just Reimu go. Reimu sign paper make spell card rule and Reimu go. And then she go beat up, but she don't kill. But it was pretty good. I liked it. The scenes, the action scenes are pretty sick. And none of the characters were treated as like, none of the characters were just treated like tropes. You know what I mean by that? Like, you know how sometimes when you look at fan works and a character's... There are bits of a character's personality that are they're attached to that they can never escape. And then their character is just created with only that in mind. Think of like, here's my example. We only work with sauce. Oh my god, you're right. I had the name of it. Hold on, chat. Let me get the name of it. Where is it? Two Scarlet Sacraments Under the Starry Sky. That's what it was. But yeah, no, it was. I thought it was pretty good. No wonder you're the Kanto champion. And why would you even try to fight me? Okay, there we go. Well, trust me, we only just started, kid. Remy. A little Remy up front. Just because you beat a couple of grunts doesn't mean you can beat Team Rocket. We'll show everyone who's still the baddest around. Yeah, it's good. It's about 100-something chapters long. It does a good job portraying the characters. There's a bit of fanon backstory in there for Remilia and Flandre, which that's either your cup of tea or it isn't. But we don't have anything on them anyway, so it's fair game. I kind of like the ideas that we know they're vampires and they're probably somewhere in Europe, but you can decide yourself if they went against Sokyo because they got bored or because they were chased out, because people don't like vampire. If there's anything I learned from watching Castlevania is that if you do something that makes vampire angry, you're probably going to explode or doom the entire world. One or the other. Between you and me, I think holding a sick Bodhika hostage is kind of low, but that's the commander's orders. There we go. The commander doesn't want to be stirred by some punk. I'm gonna have to ask you to leave. Darkness Dragon. Chaos Emperor Dragon. Envoy of the End. Best card.
It's best card in game!
I'm all for tropes. That hurts. And whatnot, but yeah. In the case of like Chirno or Mailing, Chirno is not very smart. I know Chirno is not very smart. But in order to write that kind of character good, you're not supposed to just... What's the term? It's show, don't tell. That's what it is. If you want to portray Chirno as a dummy head, you just need to express it in the way she reacts and responds. But if you just have a character be like, "Damn, Chirno, you're pretty dumb, aren't ya?" It's like, okay. Alright, well, okay. Is Chaos Emperor Dragon even legal anymore? I mean, I don't think it was ever legal to begin with. I should ask, is it legal at all, ever? Yeah, there are all kinds of tropes. I think there's nothing wrong with utilizing a trope if you're going for like comedy, but like I just prefer that they're written in a way that is, I don't want to say good, but I guess written in a way that doesn't treat your audience like they have no idea what's going on. That kind of thing. It's like I know Chirno is not very smart. I don't suppose you'd leave if I asked nicely, would you? Actually, I will because I need to heal. Bye. As long as the tropes are well executed, I don't mind them. But sometimes especially in, like, modern anime, sometimes tropes don't have to be anything. Sometimes they try to be meta about it, too, which I think is even more obnoxious. Because sometimes it'll be like, oh, you have tsundere tropes, and then everyone in the show is like, oh, you're like a tsundere, and it's like, no, I'm not. And it's like, just because you're acknowledging them doesn't really change the fact that you're utilizing them in a very piss-poor manner. As I said, there's nothing inherently wrong with tropes, but I think it's just about being able to write a character around them and not have it define the character itself. If that makes sense. Furiarada was legal for a short time as one of the main components of the Yada lock. I like how the Yatagarasu and Chaos Emperor Dragon were paired together at one point in history, and the more obnoxious card of the two of them was the Yatagarasu, not the Chaos Emperor Dragon Envoy of the End. That is so baffling. There we go. This is such a weird... What? Ha ha ha, even if you got this far, the commander is a whole other league from the rest of us. You can't stop Team Rocket. What? So it's you again. Aren't you just the most annoying little thing? Well, you won't be after today. When I defeat you, you'll join the other hostages back there. The league will pay a fortune to get both a gym leader and their champion back. That guy is the guard from the front. Oh, that makes sense. Alright, here's Proton again. Oh, shit. Big Flan. Big sword. Pardon me. I understand what Envoy of the End did to enable the Yatagarasu, because it would clear the field and whatnot. Because basically, the Yatagarasu works because it's a spirit monster. It hits you, and if it hits you directly, you can't draw. And if you don't have any cards to play in that moment, then you just get chip damage to death. That's what makes it so scary. You press evasion once, and you dodge everything. That's unbelievable. Never mind, I got a crit. Works out. It works out. Remy keeps beating Flandre. Attack Yugi. That is 100% surf. I almost switched into the wrong character because I read S and I thought that it was Suiko. Yeah, just do surf. Their levels are getting scary. I guess Suika could just fire punch her and we're good. Big punch. Whoops. There we go. You need Sangen or Witch of the Black Forest in the field when you triggered Chaos Emperor Dragon, since Chaos Emperor Dragon nukes your own hand and field as well. It destroys everything. Fucking everything. Kaboom! Why is that neutral? What? Why is that neutral? I guess flying would have been perfectly fine anyway. I think he's gonna heal, so I'm gonna go for a tailwind. Uh-oh, he didn't heal. Okay, well, I resist that at least. I think she might be Earth or something, which means this should be super effective. Okay, it is. So whatever she is, she's resistant to fire, and all I can think of is Earth. Be after. It's fine, I have a tailwind up, and now I'm definitely faster. So I'll just press the soar button. Saying in itself is searchable thanks to the Mystic Tomato. I love the Mystic Tomato because it's such a stupid looking card. It's just a fucking tomato with a stupid ass face. I had two of them. One of them had silver text. I like that one. No, I can't believe I lost again. Gah, you beat me three times now. How is such a little brat so strong? Ugh, Archer's gonna be mad at me for bungling this up. As for you, I'll see you again. And next time, I won't be holding back. The Shibi Sanai has a look of concern for the ill Natori. This Natori seems to be breathing heavily. She doesn't seem to notice anyone else nearby. Hello there. Thank you for helping back there. You see, they got the jump on me when I was tending to Akari. Sanai tried to fight back, but he was just too strong. But there's still a rather large problem. Akari's condition has gotten worse. There's a place that sells strong medicine across the sea, but can't leave Akari's side. Please, could you go get the medicine? Yeah, I gotcha. I'll do it for you. Mystic Tomato is one of the only cards with a Japanese artwork as censored compared to the American. Why? What's so bad about the Mystic Tomato? Who's Akari? The Kappa. That's its name. You know there's more than one Kappa, but Natori is the only one we ever see. Kind of like how there's a whole society of Tengu, but we only know three of them. It really be that way. Actually, Aya has Aeroblast. Aeroblast actually came in handy once, so it's good. We do see other Kappa in the manga, but the only named Kappa we've ever gotten is Natori, and Natori always seems to be the ringleader of She seems to be the ringleader of every single business opportunity, like, or at least a spokesperson. She's the face of Kappa society, and I can't tell if that's because she's a high-ranking one, or it's just because she's the only one we know, so she's always the one that shows up to make the most sense. We don't know anything about their society. Same with the Tengu. We know more about the Tengu society than them, but even then, that's not saying much. The Kappa Trio from Genso Wanderer. Yeah, I know what you're talking about. I remember those three. Let me play that game sometime. Are you going to see him? What? How about a quick battle first? I just like how her height is relative to how the artist is feeling. So in Forbidden Scrollery, Natori is like half the size of Mamizo, but then everywhere else, she's like taller than a fairy. Oh, this is Defense Silico. You might be part Earth, but I can't tell. Oh, fuck it, let's see. You are not, okay. There's the fanmate Kappa, Natori. That's Natori's sister, right? The one with the lock on her chest, who has the ability to stop things. Be fair, Mamizo's really tall. Oh no, you need to look at it. Like, when Natori approaches Mamizo, she's like half her size. And she's so adorably tiny. Yeah, I know who you're talking about. She's a fan character, but she seems to be kind of popular because I guess her idea is kind of neat. Fan characters can become popular if their concepts are neat enough that they can reasonably be believed to be canon. I don't know anything about fan characters, though. Just that one. Only that one. I think only that one. Yeah, just that one. Obviously, there are fan characters made for fan games, but I don't know. The most popular one, Concealed the Conclusion. Pretty sure that uses all official characters. And then it's got white raiment with the N. The pure white clothing. I'm not even sure where Natori came from. Obviously, she's not utilized very much because fan creations are a whole other can of worms. James 8 Clouds. Ugh, why you gotta say that? Love that guy. Rin Satsuki? The difference between Rin Satsuki and Natori is that Rin Satsuki was real at some point. She existed. She might be the one instance of a Toho character just being completely scrapped. I mentioned before that Zun stated in an interview that the original plan, one of the original concepts for Toho 16 was to beat Okina with a season and then have to redo the main story with the fifth season. And he said that if that had been the case, he would have had to create a different extra stage boss, which didn't end up happening because we got Okina as the extra stage boss, which is probably for the better because Okina herself has a lot of spell cards that aren't related to the seasons that she gets to use. But I still wonder about what that extra stage boss could have been if it had gone that way. It never reached a point in development where the character even existed, so you don't need to speculate on that. But it is cool to think about how there was a point, there would have been a point in time where there would have been a completely different extra stage boss. The only part that's really confusing is that since the main story of Toho 16, like, is supposed to be concluded in the extra stage, but at the same time the extra stage itself doesn't really offer any story, like, or any real, like, ending, it's... The only ending you have to work with is uncompleted. It's kind of weird. I like Okina a lot as well, yeah. The written work's really sold me on her. The most amazing part about Okina is that she hasn't really shown up that much, but the small amount of appearances she has made has left such a grand impact on me that I can't help but, like, look forward to seeing more of her. You can tell that she's a badass. Same with Eternity Larva, actually. Eternity Larva is a character that I just disregard as the Stage 1 boss, but Visionaries, the 2019 volume of Sengetsusei with Clown Piece as the star, had Eternity show up and do things, and I was like, damn, Eternity might actually be a little bit more than I was expecting. So, my original opinion of Toho 16 was the first four stage bosses are kind of whatever, but An is dog-like, so she's popular, and Okina's kind of cool, I guess. It's cool to see a god like that. I was more interested in Tan Chirno, but my current opinion of Toho 16 is that Okina's a really cool character, and I'm looking forward to seeing more of her. I'm very curious about what Eternity Larva is going to be like, and An is great. I now know why An is really good, because An also appears in the written works, and is just... she's a great character. She's a very helpful little girl, that's for sure. She's also very smart. So, we don't see anything on... We've seen a little bit on Narumi, actually. Narumi showed up once at Korindo and insulted Sumireko. So I like her now... I like her more now because of that than I did before. Nemuno has not appeared, like, at all. Because Yamabiko just don't... No, I had the wrong... I got the wrong species for that. Chat, what species of yokai is Nemuno? And then Mai and Satono? Yes, I finally remember their names. Mai is the green one and Satono is the purple one. Yes, I finally remembered. I don't care about them. They just have shoes on their head. That's about the best I got. I don't really think they're that interesting. They just seem to exist. But even when Okina herself now exists in canon and shows up, they don't make appearances with her, so it's like, whatever. I do think they have a good theme, though. I'll give them that. Wildhorn Hermit made me like An a lot. I agree to that. An was portrayed very well in the later chapters of Wildhorn Hermit. That's also where Okina made her first appearance in the written works as well, where she made a huge impact on me in this one chapter. Where she so confidently showed up to the shrine and was like, yeah, I'm kind of a big deal. And then left, and I was like, whoa, hold on. She kind of legit. And of course, Tenshi. I already liked Tenshi to begin with around that point in time, but when Tenshi showed up for Wildhorn Hermit, I was like, okay, yep, this is top character. And it's just relaxing, floating like this. Is it? I hate water routes. Tenshi made the last 10 chapters of Wildhorn Hermit so much better. I can't imagine what that series... Well, I mean, the series would have been great even without her, but the fact that she came back in such a silly way... Hecate's appearance in Visionary. Yep. Hecate is another character that I didn't care much about. But now I've seen her in written works. It's nice to fish alone, and it's very relaxing. Now that I've seen her in the written works, I like her character a lot more. Because she's definitely going to play she's probably going to end up playing a big part somewhere down the line. We know she's a popular character. And she's quite strong. Ow! Ooh! Ow! Ooh! Ooh! I don't know where I last saved. I hope it was close. Okay, it wasn't that bad. It wasn't that bad. Well, that hurt. And that was completely unexpected. This time, maybe I won't talk to him. Remember, shows how much time passes between 2015 and 16 is at least one of there. Yeah, there's been quite a time frame of passing, but Marissa and Rainbow don't seem to change. But yeah, back on Hecatea. Hecatea shows up to educate Clown Piece, sort of, in 2019, the fourth volume of Sengetsu Say. She also appears in Alternative Facts of Eastern Utopia with, in an interview with Aya, where she states her intentions and... Not her intentions, but she states her opinions on Gensokyo. And her opinions on how Gensokyo handles matters, and it's nice, I like that, I really like that. We made it. Alright, if this guy hates me, I'm never gonna talk to him again. I agree with her opinions on Lunarians. Oh, they mean they're all stuck up prick assholes? Yeah, they are. Even to an extent, Aiden is as well. Aiden's very full of herself. Kaguya, I'm not sure about though. Seems like she just kind of mellowed out. Tay was an Earthling to begin with, and Raisin's not really Lunarian anymore. I don't know about Ringo or Seiden though. Scared Aya enough to not have her fabulous fake stories. That's the thing, yeah. her post-article interview with Hecatea in Alternative Facts was probably the best part about that entire thing. The second part was about Sukuna winning Whitewater Rafting Doubles Division with Wagasaki Hime. That was another good one. An interaction between Hecatea and Okina. Well, if you've seen Sengetsu Say Volume 4, you can tell how Okina regards Hecatea, which would make an interaction between those two very interesting indeed. Ringo and Seiden hecked off to Gensokyo so they don't have to deal with the moon people anymore. Yep, and now they opened competing Gongo stalls. I guess the idea, or the lore for that is Saturn's Dongo is more plain and less expensive as a result, but Ringo is a more sophisticated taste, so she is more variety, but is more expensive. I don't know if that's true at all, but that seems like it would make sense for the two of them. Regular Notori. Big Aya. I called Yuko a big eater once, and Yuko was like, why would you do that to me? At least their thunderbolts are neutral on me. the X-Moon Rabbit designs. I like Raisin. Raisin gets a lot of shit, and she's treated pretty poorly by a lot of characters, and that makes me feel bad. But I like her, even if she is a bit of a coward. Visionaries was surprisingly really good. I wouldn't say it's surprising, but I think it was more surprising than how serious it ended up getting at the end of it. Because for the most part, I just assumed that Sengetsu Sei was just like essentially comedy with the fairies, and for the most part it was, but there were actually a few moments in that series that were pretty serious. Like there's the tree that got struck by lightning that the fairies moved into and behind the shrine. And how Yukari had to come make sure that the fairies moving into it weren't strong at all, so they wouldn't be able to utilize the position. Because it was right on the tree was like right on the barrier. So if a stronger presence had been on there, it could have been really bad. So Yukari tested them to make sure they were weak enough to just be able to stay there, and they passed. So that was a very serious manner. And then of course, Volume 4 with Clown Piece. I don't want to spoil it, but there's a pretty big issue going on against Sokyo involving fairies, and the fairies themselves, like, they get together and they try to figure out what's going on, and then they end up having a confrontation with Okina, which is why Okina shows up at the end. So I don't want to say any more than that, because it's not that long a read. It's like 15 chapters. You can probably read it to yourself in a day or two. And there's a surprising amount of substance to it, given what you're expecting, I guess is the way to say that. Because it actually has some very interesting stuff for canon, as opposed to just being comedy relief of the three fairies. It also reveals Hikati as one of Hikati's motivations for being around Gensokyo as well, which is kind of a big deal. Type you are. I think you're poison reason. Miasma reason. Very nice character moments for Clown Piece. Yeah. I like Clown Piece before because I thought Clown Piece was just goofy. But Clown Piece as a character really developed in that. It was a very short amount of time, but they managed to develop Clown Piece quite well, in my opinion. Okay, I don't know where I am anymore, and I need to be careful I don't talk to anyone who's going to destroy my game. She doesn't live with Reimu, she lives under the shrine. She doesn't pay rent. Reimu kicked her out once, but then she came back. Because the only place in Gensokyo that Clown Piece can actually live is under the shrine. She can't reside in nature because her affiliation with fire causes problems. She's the only fairy in Gensokyo capable of residing under the shrine. Because no one else wants to do that, because fairies are scared of Reimu, because Reimu is not very nice to fairies. Fairies are treated like pests. Clown Piece also heats the floor, yes. However, when she lights fires under the floor, that's when Reimu gets pissed. It's all recon, baby. Clown Piece's punishment's all recon. Colonel. Hikati has got a plan. She's doing more than shopping at Hot Topic. Seriously, why does that character's outfit look like that, but she's actually a very serious character? It's so confusing to me. Like, she'll drop some real interesting stuff, and then you just have to look at her with her Welcome to Hell shirt. Her crop top Welcome to Hell and her colored skirt. It's just like, what? Why? Is that trendy? I think it's a little bit behind the times. Chat, here's a question. Does Clown Piece's hat have bells? Like, when she walks, does her head jingle? I can't tell if they're like bells or they're like, what do you call it? Like, this little puffball is like the end of a Santa hat. Thank you, Demo, for getting another sub.
Colonel!
I'm not even sure what's happening anymore. I'm just hitting things. Mindlessly hitting things. Her outfit is inspired by death metals and taught the process of hell, Shinigami, death god's death, death metal. I don't... What... But her outfit looks more like, less like death metal and more like what teenagers think death metal is. I don't know. I just think her outfit is... If you don't know anything about her character and you see her outfit, your opinion of her probably won't be the highest. But now that I know more about her character, I do like her, and I can look past the outfit. It's just really weird. It's just such a weird choice is all. Like, character outfits for the most part are just kinda, they kinda make sense. But then hers is just so off the wall that I just don't know what's going on with it. Oh, the idea of Clompy's wearing the American flag just to piss off the moon people. I like how Zun stated that she's basically a clown because clowns are scary, and she wanted, and Zun wanted the fifth stage boss to be scary. So it was just a no-brainer for him. And there we go. Because when you think fear, you think of clowns. Zun's art for clown piece is zoom enough that I can't tell they're harmless pom-poms or bells. That is definitely an issue with Zun's work. I said it before, but Zun's art is enough to get the important details down. But there are some situations where it's not necessarily the case. For example, did you know that Murasa is wearing a skirt? But for quite a while, people thought she was wearing, like, short pants. Myself included. I couldn't tell she was wearing a skirt. I thought it was, like, shorts. And I like the idea of her in shorts. Because she'd be, like, one of the few characters who were wearing those. Everybody else is wearing a skirt or a dress or something. But turns out it was a skirt. But I think that at this point it's so solidified that it was pants that's what we're going with. Like, see right there? That looks more like pants, but that is roughly what it looked like in the UFO art, and people weren't sure if it was a skirt or if it was pants. And I think we've all just kind of assumed that it was pants to a point where it's become accepted. It's just accepted. So it is a skirt. In canon, it is a skirt, but I like the shorts more. Mostly because, as I said, the only other character at this point in time who was wearing, like, shorts like that was Chiuri, and she's from PC-98. He's not the first character to wear pants, mind you, but I just mean, like, the shorts themselves. Pseudo-canon. Yeah, I guess that's the best way to say it. Wriggle? Well, Wriggle is not wearing shorts. She's wearing, would you say they're shorts? Don't they go down to, like, her ankles? Aren't they called khakis? I thought the definition of shorts was they go up to at least your kneecaps. Short enough. That's, you can't say that. You can't just say short enough and call it a day. What do you think this is, the internet? You think you can just give me a weak-ass argument and post an emote and be good? No. Not around here. Pants enough, then. Terrible. How long do you think we'll need for Yin Yang? Or, I doubt we're gonna beat it. I highly doubt I'm even gonna beat that section I was stuck on, to be honest with you. That shit is going to take me hours. Whether or not I actually get through it is another question entirely. Irregular Suiko. That's neutral, actually, so it's probably better just use Sword. Faith aspect is annoying hitting her. Give me the definition of shorts, chat. Give me the absolute definition of shorts, because Wriggle's pants are not as short as what Murasa or Chiuri are wearing, that's for sure. Above the knee. Above the knee. comfy and easy to wear. God damn it. Yeah, just a bunch of jokers. Most of the trainers on this route didn't exist. You know, that was probably a better thing. I hate water routes, dude. I hate looking around them for trainers to beat up. I see the- look at them all. You look so elegant, Ryan, your Bonica. I remember this route because I had to do all of it in Crystal Kaiser. The definition is short pants. Okay, but then why do we call them short shorts? We have short shorts and then- wait, chat, what about jorts? Hmm? What about jorts? Now that's powerful. How about we give Murasa jorts instead? Does that sound good? Can anybody agree to that? Oh, whoa, what the? Oh, it was full tackle. That should have recoil, right? So it should be fine. The wiki says that Wriggle wears baggy blue knee-length shorts. Welp. I guess that's that, then. I will concede that point, then. But I still think it doesn't really... It's not the same as Murasa or Chieri, because their shorts are very... They're much shorter. I don't know why I expected this to turn out any different. Well... Damn it. Type for you again? I don't even remember. What is even going on anymore? Damn it. Well, at least it's right over here. There's no one in this Pokemon Center. Oy boy. What an interesting conversation about character outfits. For the most part, one outfit is done. The other thing about Wildhorn Hermit that I like is that the artist was given a bit of freedom to make different outfits for the characters. They're not too different, mind you, but like there's enough difference in them that they can look like winter clothing or summer clothing and stuff like that. Added layers or removed layers. I've seen versions of Rayma where she's just wearing a poofy undershirt. I've seen versions of Rayma where she's just literally just wrapped in bandages from her chest to her belly button. And it's like, okay. Okay. Imagine getting up every single day and wrapping yourself from the belly button all the way up to your boobs. Every single day. At that point, I just put a baggy shirt on. Come on now. Oh, I just healed, man. There's a whole different plethora of Raymus in the world. Sometimes they draw a Rayma with a bow bigger than her entire head. Like, she could probably use that to create air. Well, I is too high level now anyway, so I'll just switch her placement up. Go racing, I guess. Rosa wears military sailor-style Bermuda shorts, like the one the Brits use in tropical countries. That's actually a skirt, but it could be whatever you want it to be. That's the thing. It's not in canon. It's not shorts. That was the whole debacle. Yeah, Rainbow's bow and Genso Wander is just it's a bit much. It's really fucking big. Alright, we're gonna explore the caves and catch the, Lugia. Here we go. I don't remember which entrance it is, so I'm just gonna go in this cave and hope it works. I hate you, Dev. You put last remote in here and you make me need flash. course Aya can learn it. Why wouldn't Aya be able to learn Flash? Hold on. You know the worst part about this is I can't even fly. I have to walk. I have to manually walk back to the PC. God damn it. How do I get out of here? Can Ron learn Flash? She should be able to learn Flash. Hold on, I'm going back to CN Wood. There we go. She's glad there's no whirlpools. They wouldn't be able to make whirlpool in HM. Oh, goodness gracious. I forgot the Tuket. She has a rainbow shard. Gentle nature. Very fitting. Serene grace. Okay, you have agility, attract. What does Lunatic do? A lunatic attack that may lower the opponent's special defense. Neat. And then Sendai. Why was it level 5? Quiet nature. Faith. Hakure Miko. And Seal Needle and Imprison. Okay, so that's basically rainbow. Who learns Flash? Oh, Aya does, duh. Racing does too, but I don't have another Racing. Where's Hatate? Hatate should be able to learn Flash. Okay, let's see. I'll bench Aya, because Aya is the highest level. I don't think there are any trainers in there anyway. Is that a tank? It's Rika. So, yes. Rika's from Toho, too. She is a human, and her boss fight is against the flower tank in stage 1. So, you fight her, but she's in a tank. And then she's also the extra stage boss, where she's an Evil Eye Sigma, which is a robot giant Evil Eye. At least, I think it's a robot. It's supposed to be a robot, but it doesn't really look like it. But yeah, Rika's actually the first boss of the shmup variant of Toho. So she's got a special milestone attached to her name. She's a really sick sound. Yeah. Cause the thing is, in the original Toho 2, she doesn't actually have any like character model herself. She's just a little character box, and you fight the tank, not her. It's also the first extra stage boss ever. That's true. It was the first instance of a character from the game showing up as the extra stage boss. The second instance was Alice, and the third instance was Okina. I don't count mid-bosses. Maybe I should have checked. Okay, good. Imagine if I came all this way and she couldn't learn it. And there we go. Now let's use Flash. Ooh, this is a very good part of the song. Excellent. One of my favorite parts. So they actually use a cell phone? Yes. Oh! It's new! But it's not Shibi new. You can't run from that? How in the hell are you not able to run away from that? She's that fast. She must be Electrode. I didn't buy the smoke ball. Why did I not buy the smoke ball? 148, 154, 181, 191, 165. Good thing I boxed my fastest Pokemon. Fucking genius I am. Remy should be fast enough to escape. Alright. Stegalang around. Yeah, repels. I don't buy repels, because I can just run from everything. There's Yukari. If I get irritated by encounters, I just hold the speed up button. That's it. Still have strength at least. Why is Lorelei there? How strange. Whose ability is to be an illusion that can't be comprehended? She's not a shapeshifter. She just steals the form of objects. So they become incomprehensible. Mamizo transforms though, because she's a Tanook. Dev? What's this? This beach is too clean. Fix it. Okay, where the hell am I? I don't remember the way to Lugia. At all. I never liked this. Four caves, only one of them leads to the legendary. It's like Mount Mordor. Oh, well. There's you again. What? Not this one. Cool, I got an item for it though. Maybe it's this one. Let's try going that one. Yeah, let's try this one. Wait, there's a trainer there. Dev. He tricked me. Listen, I love cosplaying as Chinese girl. The great number of cosplayers nowadays make me happy, but somehow I get tired of Japanese costumes. I wonder if this 4,000 years old China dress will fit on you. Thanks, that probably increases dream type moves, doesn't it? This slit, sexy, charming China dress that I gave you earlier will increase the power of dream type moves for who wears it. Okay, that was a bit more explanation than I wanted. But okay. Forget what those are called, but I know what it is. I know what the type of dress is. She just got way too descriptive with it. Xiong-san. Yeah, that. Thank you. They look nice. Ooh, a full restore. Just in case I need it. Oh, Goliath. Alice didn't even get a chance to use that doll. Channel blew it up. What a strange combination of final bosses for 12.3. We have Big Doll, giant robot and giant catfish. Why there's so many giant enemies in 12.3? That doesn't even make sense. Channel Blue Goliath Sword Alice hasn't had a speaking role for 9 years. But I mean, she shows up in Sengetsusei and talks to the fairies. But that's about it. A waterfall. Do you have any idea how much I dislike seeing that there? Because I do not have Notori with me. Oh no. Oh no. That's Prisoku? You're probably right, actually. Because if I remember... that depends, because Fairy Wars came out, it was 12.5. Fairy Wars came out around the time of Volume 2, right around the midpoint, I think? Because I know there was a chapter in Sengetsusei, in Volume 2, that is the build-up to the events of Fairy War, where the three fairies instigate Chirino into a big fight, and that's how Fairy Wars starts, and then Fairy Wars is the game. But I'm pretty sure the fairies talk to Alice in Visionaries, though. Although I can't remember. She might not have, but if she didn't, then yeah, it's been a long time. Alice has disappeared. She used to be so prominent, too. That's the crazy part. Even a character like Remilia. I mean, I guess she has shown up again in written works quite a few times, but... some of the older characters just don't get any light to them. And if you were an older character and weren't that popular, you're probably in the, probably out of the sunlight forever. Even Flandre came back. I don't want to find items, I want to find Lugia. Yeah, I'm caught up on Cheating Detective and Lotus Eaters now. Both very good, but I know they're gonna update very slowly, and I'm gonna be wanting more. I still don't understand where Lotus Eaters is going in terms of plot, but I also understand that the main plot of those series don't really happen at all. It's just a lot of mishmash stories until like the last couple chapters, like the last two even, and that's when the big conclusion happens. So basically what's probably gonna happen is we're gonna get a lot on Mioi, and then the last two chapters of the final volume are gonna be like, alright, here's the big plot, and that's it. That's what we get. The last chapter of Lotus Eaters was great because it finally established a location that I've been wondering about for a long time. A yokai-only bar. I've always wondered about that, because I know fan art, there was always cool fan art. Alright, but this wasn't the right one either, was it? Of just characters drinking at a bar, but it's like, is there any location like that in Gensokyo? Turns out there wasn't. This whole time there was not. And now there is officially one. And it's the Gyuriden. The Gyuriden After Hours. And now it's a yokai exclusive pub. Okay. I'm gonna pull Notori out in case I end up needing Waterfall. Villager with mutton chops, one of the, it went hard on the fan theory of Gensokyo is just a yokai cattle farm. You know, he's not entirely incorrect. But they don't eat the humans. But the funny thing is his fear of that is what is actually the nourishment that the yokai use. So it's kind of interesting when you look at it like that. There we go. I'm gonna head back now. There should be one more cave I haven't checked. Which one haven't I checked, Chad? I don't even remember. The one on the far right? I'm pretty sure the one on the far right was the one I used. Okay, I've been in that one, so it's not that one. The northeast one. Yeah, the one I used in Crystal Kaizo. And I'm checking everything else, though. This should be the one, then. You can't touch the human village. Without the human village, the yokai would cease to exist. However, the humans themselves don't know that, because if they did, then they would probably no longer fear the yokai. If humans learn that their fear is what gives yokai their life, if all they had to do was stop fearing the unknown, and they'd be fine. So, obviously, the yokai wouldn't want that to happen. It's a very interesting thing. I mentioned before that Toho canon is pretty cool. It does have some ounce of seriousness to it that is... you can enjoy. I don't know which way to go. I hate this. What are my choices here? More Goliaths. Where does Sankey Bonky stay? She lives in the human village, but she... you can't really tell she's a yokai just by looking at her. The only aspect about her that's yokai-ish is her neck, but she just covers it. However, she's very, Ooh, look at that. It seems she's very... what's the word? She sticks out because she's kind of... I guess, what's the best way to say this? I don't have a word right now for it. This should do. But yeah, she does live in the human village, but there are yokai that do visit the human village. It's just they tend to disguise themselves as all. Like, Mamizo. Mamizo disguises herself when she visits the human village. When the one time Suika visited the human village before, and she wore a giant hat to cover her horns. And then one time she just fucking showed up in front of Mioi, in front of the bar. And she's like, yo, I'm here, midday, horns completely out, and people were just looking at her, and Mioi's just like, what are you doing? I fucking love Suika. Oh my god. Chat. It him. I'ma get him. Let's get that para. Dev. Dev. Why would you do that? You know I can't use save states. Why would you do that to me? I don't have a way to stop that from happening. Which means... we're just gonna have... how am I supposed to catch it by throwing balls at it full health? I used my lunatic orb already on Sario because I forgot to save because I didn't. Oh, who could have expected this? We're gonna be here for the next forever. Please buckle down, make yourself some food, and we will cool. has Fly, Meteor Mash, and Explosion. Okay. Oh, okay. He's not using the move, chat. Why is he not using the move? I don't want to invite misfortune, but why is he not using the move? Mm-hmm. Oh, what? Oh, okay. Good. A giant robot. Some say it is steam powered, sort of resembles a huge balloon robot. Okay. Give a nickname to Tensoku? No. I got him. Gotcha, bitch. Catch rate 45. Oh, his catch rate is good. That would make sense. 2 feet tall. Shh. Small. Alright, let me get the hell out of here. I don't wanna be in this location anymore. I'm scared. I'm gonna talk to her and the game's gonna crash. Listen, listen. I love cosplaying as princess. The whipping candles are just perfect. Eh? You said that it's not princess. Just shut up. Do you want me to whip you too? Oh, I got it. Yeah, great. Thanks. The thing I gave you is dangerous bondage suit that will increase the power of dark type moves. Mm-hmm. No, I am not giving it to Remy. Bye-bye. Fuck this place. Now I no longer have to do that ever again. I don't know why I keep seeing these characters and I'm like, oh, what are they here? And then they're the cosplayers every time. Every fucking time they're the cosplayers and I don't pick up on that at all. Now we can continue the plot. Hell yeah. Let me do my box sorting and my healing. Very good. Very, very good. Oops. Okay. It has a PP max. Jolly nature. Maintenance heals the body by shedding. That's pretty good. PP max, yeah. Bulk up, meteor mash, fly, and explosion. Okay. Why? Why does it have explosion? At least you didn't make its catch rate 3. Guilty Gear stuff? Nope. I just know that what happened. I guess the feedback was not good. And they were like, we're listening, we're listening, we'll fix it. And I haven't heard anything since. Chuck the gym leader spars with his fighting Bonica. 500 years of tradition, Sandwood Pharmacy, we await your medicinal queries. Why'd you put the sign like this? Sorry, but my husband's not home right now. He ran out of herbs to make his medicine with, so he's out to gather more. Arda. A trainer. If you beat the gym leader here, come see me. I'll have a nice gift for you. I don't want what you're selling. Leader Chuck, his roaring fists do the talking. Okay. came from Olivine. Do you remember the four islands along the way? I heard that a mythical sea creature is hiding in them. No, it was a robot. But you can only see if you have a certain item. It must be the same scent as the creature. No, it's a robot. I heard that the whirlpools around the islands are caused by the sea creature. No, it's a robot. Someone's gotta educate these people. If you just fly, you can get back to Olivine instantly. Somebody really needs to tell this man how this world works, because he is not correct. A burrow to the north of town could be crushed. They may be hiding something. Your buddy could use rock smash to break them.
Crush.
I see. There's no Shuckle House. Good job. But there is access to the Safari Zone. Which is kind of strange that this exists. Okay. I don't remember what the route to the Safari Zone looks like in Heart Gold and Soul Silver. So I couldn't tell you if this is accurate or not. Someone else is gonna have to do that part. That looks fine to me so far. Oh, hello there, young lady. It's a nice day out, isn't it? I'm just gathering herbs right now, so if you want to make some medicine, you'll have to wait until I'm done. Can't make anything with no stuff to make with that, not at all. In other words, go beat up Chuck, you dumbass, and then the story can progress. You might as well just make him say, like, shouldn't you be doing something important, like fighting Pokey? Because I am idiot, and I don't know what I'm doing unless game tell me. But if game tells me, I get mad at game, and this is what it means to be gamer. Disregard tutorials, complain about lack of direction. Alright, Chucky. Maybe, what's good against Chuck? Dark and Beast. So, I think Remy is a good lead. If I run into another speed mailing, though, I'm not gonna be very happy. We martial artists fear nothing. I do appreciate that when somebody doesn't read the tutorial, and then immediately fucks up what the tutorial just told them, it's referred to as grumping it. Because that's probably the most accurate thing I've ever heard. So remember, chat. If I get a tutorial, and I don't read it and fuck up, I grumped it. But I won't do that, because I make sure to lead. I make sure to read everything. And then sometimes my brain is melted, so I don't actually process anything of what I just read. My Bonica and I are bound together by friendship. Our bond will never be broken. Okay. Regular mailing. I'm more worried about speed mailing being as fast as she is. Thrash takes everything else out, though. There we go. One thing that Game Grumps has taught me is that when you criticize a game, and then you show how your complete ability to play said game, your criticisms kind of fall. Just a bit. And to play devil's advocate on that subject, you don't need to be the best player at a video game to understand why a game good and why a game bad. But when you criticize mechanics and then do not utilize them yourself at all, I don't know, it's kind of like pouring a cup of water in a strainer and trying to drink. It's not really gonna work. I don't think it's necessarily a bad thing to ignore tutorials. I mean, if you do, that's on you. That's egg on your face. What I don't like is when you blame the game for not telling you how you're supposed to do something because you willingly skipped the part of the game that tells you how to do it. That's on you. That is 100% on you. That's where most of the flack comes from. It's not the lack of reading, It's the complaints about lack of direction. It doesn't even matter of understanding it so much as it's just like blatant disregard. Oh, that's Chuck. Oh, that's not Chuck! My Raging Fist will shatter your Bonica. Just a blatant disregard for the instructions, and then when the instructions are skipped over, it's complaining that there weren't any instructions at all. I mean, I used to watch Game Grumps, don't get me wrong. I remember watching their Wind Waker playthrough, and they uploaded an entire hour-long session of just them beating the Wind Temple. And I'm pretty sure they were at least halfway through it at that point anyway. It took them an hour to beat that temple. Kotohime. I'll just bite her. Shit happens. When you talk to someone, it's easy to lose direction. That's for sure. I understand that part. But sometimes there's just such a blatant, like, ignoring of what you're supposed to do in its entirety that no progress gets made. Compilation and repeatedly dying in Mario 64 is Descent of the Man is probably my favorite grunt related video. When did they play that? I can't remember the last grunt video I watched. It's been a while. I remember when I first started watching them though. When I first started watching them, they only had 60 videos. This is John and Aaron. They had Goof Troop played, they were playing Mega Man, and they were playing Pokemon Emerald. So I've seen a few of them, and I've watched them for a long time. But I guess, I don't know. I just stopped, really. That's all there is to it. I thought they were funny. I did. I guess I just don't care anymore. They're still pretty successful, though, so they're doing something right. But I guess I just got... Once you notice that you get angry at something more than you're enjoying it, it's probably best you just kind of take a moment to think about what you're doing. Like, you wanna watch somebody because you're enjoying how they play the game, right? I don't really see the appeal of watching someone so you can get angry about how they play the game. That's why I never understood hate watching. Some people will actively watch people they hate just to do it, and I don't get it. Why do you do that? Shouldn't you be trying to do something that makes you happy? But whatever. They do it because they wait for the one opportunity for something to go wrong so then they can shit talk you. And it's like, okay. And then they're just immediately like removed or ignored and they get nothing out of it. It's like, alright. And then some people wear that as a badge of honor. I got blocked by this guy because he couldn't handle my gamer attitude. It's like, alright, dude. So you've come this far, let me tell you, I'm tough. My Bonica will crush stones and shatter bones. Watch this. The PCB dojo on the same artist, the OSD one. Neat. Whoa. Chuck got a bit dark. Lyrica. How in the fuck is that? What? That's not a dream type, you idiot. I wish I used Memento. Why so pudgy? That's Chuck. Chuck is very pudgy. He's got more beer gut than muscle. My headphones fell out of my ears. Hold on. I'm working on it. I'm getting there. Runosuke has drawn line, so he's a bit scary. But not anymore. Oh, definitely not anymore. Ah! Ah! The line must be drawn here! Squishy. There goes Ghost Dream. Weird. It's the same thing with donations. People will be like, here's $5 to call you an idiot. And the person who gets $5 is probably just like, okay. Like, why? Why would you do that? Why would you actively spend some money on someone you dislike? As if your words are going to be hurtful enough to offset the amount of money you just put into it. What's the point? How about you spend that money on something you like? Thanks for the money, guess I'm an idiot. It's like, do you really think they care? Oh my fucking god, you used one double team and you're invincible. Cut, can't miss. I knew it! I fucking knew it, but I thought I'd be faster. I hate Speed Koishi. This flamethrower thunderbolt bullshit. I can't handle this combination. That better not be super effective. Okay, Jesus. That's gonna confuse me, isn't it? You used one double team. One! Finally. As long as Remy's alive, I can still win. Lyrica, go stream. Grayson's still alive, so I can use Nightmare. I dislike you so much, I'm willing to pay to make that hate manifest. That's unhealthy. That's very unhealthy. Chat, we all have people we don't like. We all have content creators that we don't want to watch, but you don't have to watch them if you don't want to. That's the best part. I just don't really see the need to go to someone's stuff and be like, hey, you suck. I don't like you. It's like, okay. Who does that help? You? Does it help them? Who does that help? Attack, Reimu. You're a faith dream. You're a bit scary. I'll keep racing it. I don't think I'm faster than her, though.
I'm about to explode! Oh, yes.
I hope High Jump Kick misses. Oh. That might be enough. Good. Well, that was annoying. Huh? I lost? How about that? I got the Storm Badge. That's the Storm Badge. Be proud, not every trainer gets one. Shows that you beat me, and if you didn't... You didn't have the Thunder Badge, I let you fly. Don't lose it now, you hear? Okay. Goodbye. People do weird things. It's the world we live in. Even though I don't necessarily understand why they do them, that's not gonna change them from doing it. Sometimes we read things on the internet that are just so confusing. They're just so confusing. And you try really hard to wrap your head around it, but it just doesn't make sense. And you can't make sense of it, no matter how hard you try. Just seeing what's gym bad, and you should take this HM. Thanks for the rainbow shard. My husband lost you, so he needs to train harder. That's good, since he was getting a little chubby. Ooh! Ooh! That hurts, doesn't it? I don't know, Chad. I just read something last night that just confused me. Beyond all belief. And I just don't get it. I thought about it for so long, and I can't. I wonder if he's standing on something. No, I don't want to. I don't want to say what it is because I don't want to give it attention because I think it's just fucking stupid. It's just confusing, convoluted mess. But what I can say, I suppose, is that sometimes when you enjoy something, there will be people in this world who enjoy it too, who will make it their life's mission to make you not enjoy it. So just be careful about who you interact with and what opinions you share on what. Welcome, this is the teleport room, and here you can teleport any Johto. Yeah, that will. I will do just that. Let's go to Johto. Yeah! Be advised. Be very advised. So, steel types are coming up. Steel types are weak to earth and fire, so this should be a Suika gym. I can probably be Jasmine. Let's go get the medicine. It's like every other fan base. I don't go on any, like, anonymous forum boards, because they're... No. I don't know enough about Dark Souls at all. I want an excuse to play Bloodborne again. I remember more about Bloodborne bosses than I do about Dark Souls bosses. But even then, I'm still a bit hazy. Hello there, thank you for your help back there. You see, they got the jump on me. Oh, there's still an HP problem. I forgot to pick up the medicine. You fucking idiot. Chat, why'd no one stop me? Why did you allow me to come all the way back to Olivine without the medicine? I don't understand. Why did you let me do this? I have to go all the way back. What a hassle. Yeah, take me back. Oh, my body. Let me in! You're not you're not the same NPC. Your Bonica appeared to be fine. Is something worrying you? Lighthouse Bonica is in trouble. I got it, so I'll do the trick. Deb, that's not the same NPC as the one that was picking the herbs in the garden, and now I'm concerned. Secret potion. It's a tad too strong, I only offering an emergency. Even now my husband works hard to make sure that the Bonica don't suffer when they're sick. Such a compassionate man. So compassionate that when he goes out picking, he shaves his sideburns and closes his eyes, and then when he comes back, he attaches his sideburns again. What a good man. I am out of here. I have the medicine now, chat. I have the medicine. Let me see what it looks like. What did you make the icon in the bag? What? It's a fake. It's not real. You made it up. Oh yeah, you really did too. Look at that. It's fake, chat. It's fake. It's not a real item. It better work. Fake medicine, better work. They make an item for this. They should probably do that. Will that medicine help? Yeah, sure. Please don't be offended, but Akari will only take this if I give it to her. There goes my earphones again. Fuck, I want headphones. I hate earbuds. They're not meant to be in your ears this long. Cock and ball torture. This will help you get better. Look, she's great. She looks like she wasn't sick at all. Okari, I'm so relieved. Thank you so much for your help. I'll be going back to the gym. If you want to fight me with my badge, excuse me. Bye. Bye. Ow. The torch seems to be perfectly healthy. The electricity flowing off her provides a bright light. I have gel earbuds. The ones that you slip in your ears. The ones that are, like, wide hurt my ears a lot. I don't know how people use those ones. But the gel ones, I don't know. They just kind of... They get stuck in there. And it's not comfortable after, like, 10 minutes. That's all I have to work with. You gotta do what you gotta do. Make use of what you got. Alright. It is time for a gym battle. Thank you for your help with the lighthouse, but this is different. Please allow me to introduce myself. I am Jasmine, a gym leader. I use the steel type. Do you know about the steel type? It's a type that was only recently discovered. May I begin? I like how she's a professional trainer of the steel type, despite it being just recently discovered. That's a very good sprite of her, actually. Technical soccer, yeah. I don't know what's better, but I'm gonna go with Earthquake. I'm very glad I went with Earthquake. Hmm. This should kill. Max power. Mimi-chan. That's the ICBM, and it's going to head smash me if this Earthquake doesn't hit it. Nice! Quick Claw! Quick Claw! Best Gen 2 girl, Jasmine or Claire. I like how you didn't even put Whitney on that list. You didn't put Whitney on that list. Yumeko. Whitney is trash and everyone knows it. Crimson Shin would like to have a word with you on that one. Video game Claire sucks, but I like, Oh, this isn't good.
Oh, that's bad.
I'm gonna go for a burn. When his tantrum makes you have to talk to her. Yeah, and then Claire's tantrum makes you have to go through a whole other side dungeon. What a fucking brat. Burn. Heartbreaker! I'll live that. It's only plus two neutral damage. I'm Suika. I'm big Suika. See? Big Suika always comes prepared. Steel Yorihime is weak to Earthquake. Uh-oh, but if I lose Earthquake, I don't have anything for her. She's part Faith. She resists fire. Ah. Quick Claw. Yeah! The Quick Claw! Nice. Saki has never got to attack me before because I'm too good. Yoki. Ooh. Double Quick Claw! Suika is best in game! You are a better trainer than me in both skill and kindness. Don't forget luck. Don't forget luck. I don't feel as if I've earned that victory. That's the mineral badge. It lets you get closer to facing the league, but I'm not sure how it'll work with a champion. So for now, it's a token for beating me. I don't know how to say this, but good luck. Thanks. Wait. Where do I go from here? Now that I have this badge, I can go back. I can go up to Mahogany Town. Okay, let's do that then. Yes, take me back to Equiteague. Can I go on the Burn Tower yet? Will you let me in? I hate earphones, man. I hate them. I go to adjust them, and then I bring my hand down, and I hit the middle, and I just bring the entire thing out of my ear. Fucking every time. Thank you, Mina, for 7 months. Oh, he's gone. Yes. I will enter this tournament. I mean, tower. I had two words with T and that's the one that came out. God damn it. Ooh. Aw. Why do I need... Oh, what the hell? Hold on. Ghost play? What's ghost play? Oh, that wasn't supposed to be super effective. I need to get, I need to go get mailing with Rock Smash. Every now and again, the sound comes in my, into my right ear, and it, like, it's there. It's always there, but it, like, it just enhances itself ever so slightly. That's speedy, Omu. Yeah, that's probably Wonder Guard, which means it has 1 HP, which means I can't weaken it. We'll find out when I catch it, because it looked cute and I want it. They're not actually ghost fairies, by the way, because since fairies can't really die, they just dress up as ghosts. They're just having fun. I'll bench Miss Aya. Where is my mailing? Orange spell cards are annoying with the fairies, though, because you have to direct them out of the way. It makes them a bit of a pain in the ass, because if you shoot them down, they expel bullets, but if you don't shoot them down, they keep shooting anyway. So what I was doing with them was I'd bring them above Orin's head, and then I'd kind of group them into her and just hold fire in the center. So that way all the bullets would come out, but they would be all in the same direction, so it was less difficult. That said, I've never actually captured or even, like, not timed out her last spell card, because I just keep going in a circle avoiding shit and I run out of time. So, I guess I just throw balls at it, because I can't do anything else. Oh my god. I didn't want this. Point. I guess go down the hole. Oh, it's the starters. You made the starters as roaming legendaries? And that would mean Alice is Suicune, I guess, because it showed up before.
Or did you?
Ooh. You'll see. Come on. Stay in ball. Nasty Plot, Memento. There's also a zombie. You know, Memento isn't actually as bad as a movie you think it is, but in this situation, it's probably one of the worst moves in the entire game. Okay, I need to find where to go. Big Yomo. Memento basically forces your opponent to switch, or they're crippled. And then you can safely switch in a setup mon. That's the appeal. That's the appeal of Memento setting up. It's just, you know, it makes you faint, so it's not really best used unless you're in a situation where you're probably going to die anyway. Oh yeah, there are trainers in here. Reminds me of another move. It doesn't make you faint, but it activates if you faint. The move Grudge. Grudge is basically Destiny Bond, but instead of taking the attacker down with it, it only removes the... It completely depletes the PP of the move that was used to take the Pokemon out. And it's like, why would I use that? Why would I restrict the Pokemon's moveset when I have a move that takes the Pokemon out? You know what really restricts the Pokemon's moveset? It being unable to battle. Spite's pretty bad too. Spite's more just annoying in story. Nasty Plot, Air Slash, Memento. Firing Shot's better than Memento. I think it's just a matter of the stage, because Memento's a minus 2 and Parting Shot's a minus 1. Only a moment Grudge would work if it takes out a mon's only attacking move. But like at the same time, wouldn't it just be better to take out the Pokemon itself? Because I feel like unless you do a very specific setup, trapping a wall with depleting its move, so you can set up to plus 6. But A, that requires Shadow Tag to exist, and that's banned, so good luck with that. And then B, why would you need such a convoluted Grudge setup? If with Shadow Tag, you wouldn't even need that. I don't know. I can see a strategy that would use Grudge, but at the same time, it doesn't seem like a very good one. I think I'd rather the Pokemon be taken out than go to plus 6, finally. It's just like, why? Grudge would be better if Destiny Bond didn't exist, but Destiny Bond is just a direct upgrade. Zombie Bonica. Typical fairies that enjoy pranking people. This time they are dressed up as zombies. Bye, Z Fairy. I kinda like Memento, simply do the massive tempo swings you can generate, do the almost guaranteed free turn it gives you to set up. Grudge is only really useful for things super reliant on a single move. But the thing is, it's only reliant on, a single move mon, which is basically any wall. But those mons use set damage more than anything. And those moves don't even hit Pokemon that can use Grudge. Seismic Toss is a popular one, but it's fighting. Memento can work. Think of it like this. There's also a move called Healing Wish. Healing Wish makes the user faint, but in return, it basically has a full restore on the next Pokemon you send out. But would you say it's better or worse than Wish? Because I think in this situation, both of these moves are usable, but in a case like Destiny Bond and Grudge, Destiny Bond is just so... Whoa! Oh. Ignore my training and look at the hole over there. Hey, do you want to battle again? Huh. What? Why? Why only him? Hold on. What? Do you, Yuko? Hold on, I wanna get the, item. That man went pale as a sheet. Damn. I didn't think I beat him that badly. That's just a zombie fairies and a bunch of the Yu-Yus. Yu-Mus and Yo-Mus. I would be terrified to run into a shiny one of those, because there's no way I would catch it. Dev! Oh, you son of a bitch. Alright. Oh, that was my fault. Allow me to show you something. That wasn't very cash money. Okay, look at this. So here's what I did, chat. I figured I would be able to fall where that item is if I fell in the one of the farthest right. Here's what I did. Evil. I tried to do that, and then it didn't go through, as you can see. And then I ate shit. There we go. That's what I expected to happen. An item's an item. An item is an item. There she is, Xiaomu. I'm gonna do a bit of grinding off stream as well, because given how the levels are going, I'm currently under-leveled, again, go figure. So I'll probably boost my levels up a bit. Just because I hate losing. I hate losing. Because I don't know what half of these mons do. And then they use one double team and then I can't kill them. It's a pain in the dick. At least there's a rebattleable trainer up here that I can pick on. I do have the Versus Seeker though, so it won't be too bad to level them up since most of these NPCs are easy to take out and give good EXP. Okay. Let's do the thing. Here we go. Get ready. Here come. I did EQ my way through Jasmine, however, I also got Quick Claw activating. So, that's the only reason that worked. I had nothing to deal with that. Because my only other coverage for steel types was Fire Punch on Remilia, and Remilia is times 4 weak to steel. Funny. Don't talk to the NPCs before I save. Quick Claw defines me as a player. Okay. Who that? Alright, chat. I'm gonna ask that you mind your ears. I'm prepared to mute it if something go wrong. I'm one of them. Okay. So who's this? Oh, it's her. The legends were true. That didn't do any damage. Don't do that. Oh, it didn't put me to sleep. So this is the interpretation of her we're going with. Of course, there isn't actually one to go with anyway, so you can do whatever the fuck you want. I got the para. That's all that matters. Nice. That's a crit. Broken. Pure illusion. Wait, what? There are illusion types? What the fuck? What is illusion weak to? Fuck off. Oh. Speak to fire. Hiya. Just got one more turn to sleep. I'm just too lucky. I'm just the luckiest motherfucker on the planet, aren't I? Okay. She's wind native. Oh, that's why Thunder Punch just nothing. Ding. 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 Good. Oh, well, that's not great. She needs to rest that off or we're in trouble. This is, for anyone who doesn't know, this character is the, I don't know if speculated is the right word here, but she was rumored to be the third main character of the EOSD game. And that obviously didn't happen. So, now she's just an urban legend. I really need you to use rest. I don't think we'll ever see anything on this character ever. However, it is definitely not a name I'm going to forget, if only because it's very easy to remember, and I like the lore behind it. She's in the code, but not too much of it. Yeah, that's where the name comes from, yeah? She is an urban legend in Limbo. Zero points. I wonder what would happen if Rin Satsuki was a character. Chad, are you guys having latency issues? Because I haven't been having them myself, but I've noticed that when I'm watching Vinny, that some people in chat are like really far behind. And they react to things that he says like a full minute later. And like, I have no idea if that's the case. I'm pretty sure Twitch is having some issues on that, but I don't know for sure. And obviously that's not really something I can tell, because it's an issue. I think it's more of not really an issue that is going to be the same for everyone. But if it's an issue on Twitch's end, it will be more apparent for many. Use the next one. I'm playing with a bad hand here because of the Z Fairy, but whatever. There's no low latency mode on mobile, I know that, so that's always going to be a thing. I didn't realize how far Twitch had come, because I remember back in the day, Twitch was like a 30-second delay of broadcast to chat, or what's actually happening. But they really improved on that system. But I was very outdated. I had outdated information. I thought it was still that bad for a long time. And it wasn't. It was better. Hmm. I don't know what the delay would be caused exactly. But yeah, I guess maybe it's just server issues, because there are different servers that you can stream off of. So maybe that's what it is. Okay. More hard orbs. Oh. Just couldn't make it easy, could you? Wait, this kills me. But you lost all your special attack, idiot. Did 11. Come on, I caught the naked angel. Why are you gonna be so difficult? Oh, if that crits me, I die though. Ah. Reaching critical points of sadness. It's been 3 hours, chat. 3 hours, and here I am staring down another legendary that I'm just... I don't want to look at it anymore. Drinking. I don't know, I don't really do that. I don't do anything. I'm boring. But that's what makes it great. A boring life is a good life. Think I can control crits? Critical hits are the worst thing in all of Pokemon. The worst. Because you can never, ever account for them. That's why I mix my alcohol with like 80% soft drink. It's just not that good of a watch. There we go. Good. Okay. And now we begin the game again. I don't know if I want to try again after this. I might just stop. Try again on a fresh palate, because I'm starting to slip. It's been 3 hours of this. Fighting gym leaders and throwing Pokeballs at this thing. The other two weren't so bad, but this one's gonna be awful, I just know it. Because, look at it! we go. Here we go. Yeah, take a nice snooze. Self-afflicted sleep is helpful, but also healing is annoying. I just needed to use Draco Meteors. I like alcohol when I can't taste the alcohol. I thought that was just a universal thing. AM fucking out there doing their stupid bullshit. Ugh. Oh, I'm so over it. I'm a very patient man. But I'm getting real sick of this. I wish. Instead, I get a steamroller that shakes the entire house. Who starts that kind of work at 6 a.m.? Who does that? Gonna catch up to me soon. It really is. It's all just gonna build up. Nothing I can do about it. Oh well. Things will get better eventually. It would be even better if you would go in the ball. Like it could be really good. How many more balls do I have to throw at you? Oh. Ugh. Oh no, the Pokemon broke free. Why does she have a violin anyway? Whatever design. What design? There's gotta be reason for this. But she doesn't have one. She's the fifth prison river. Now that's some lore. Ask the head priest tomorrow. And again, I haven't seen him, but he's there. Tomorrow's more travel mode. More buying players, yeah. Okay. She's not doing any damage anymore, but this is still oh, it's a task, alright. Thank you. What are you again? Wind nature? Wind native? Whatever the fuck. That means none of my moves hurt you for good damage at all. Nope. Nope, none of them. So that means all I can do is throw. And throw. And choke. Choke and throw and throw and choke. What Rin would have done. All I have is a name. What would be her motivations for doing anything? Marissa likes doing yokai extermination because she's bored and it's Reimu's job. So what would motivate a character like this to act upon this? Maybe she's a human from the human village? Because you gotta remember there are the locations that have been established in the lore at this point. It either would have been something like the human village, or it would have been a area made specifically for her. Because I doubt that she would also come from the Hakurei Shrine. But as far as locations go, there were very few back then. A nurse? Well, you gotta remember that it has to do with wanting to set out to stop the incident. So Reimu does it after like a couple weeks because she's lazy as fuck. And then Marissa just follows behind. But what would motivate this character? She would be an anti-bully ranger. She would be a bully hunter. Yeah. That's not good. What documentation do we have? A name and the code. That's it. There's really nothing to her. And shot types. Oh, we had shot types? I didn't know that. What did she do? Wind sign and flower sign. So that's why she's wind native, huh? Okay. It's not functional code, yeah. It's just a couple lines. Trust me, if it was functional, people would have used it at this point to figure it out. But as it is, it's so bare bones that there isn't anything they can actually do with it. It's just information. Meh. Gee, I sure would love it. If you would stay in the ball! Please? Please? Kind of reminds me of a PC-98 character. Oh, I guess she exists in Canada about as much as they do anyway nowadays, so that's not too far from the truth. I don't know how much PP this move has, but it seems to be the only thing she has left. Getting impatient. Very impatient. It either works or it doesn't. Come on. Twenty minutes later. Thank you. Ugh. She's gonna start struggling soon. I don't have Aya with me. And there it is. I can't believe that Mei Ling lived that struggle. That's unbelievable. How did she do that? Oh. Good. She can't throw punches. That's pretty bad. Even Suiko can throw a hearty punch. That's all of my heart orbs. Here, take the luxury one. Wow, look cool. I have a couple green balls left. This is one of those aspects of Pokemon that is remembered fondly, but then when you actually go back and do it, you wonder why you even think that. Game over. Game over. Oh well. I don't have the desire to resume that, so this is it. Rin wins forever. I lose. It's unfortunate, but what can you do? What a shitty way to end that. Oh well, yeah, no, my goose is cooked on that one. I don't have it in me to do it again. No, I thought I had enough time, but then I looked at it, I was like, no. And now I'm spent. I really am. Alright. So, just give me a second, and I'll be right back. And I will set up hard game. Very fun game. I'm looking forward to it. One sec, be right back.